know they gon' lean. World debut, I know they gon' fiend. Everything Mississippi to the Palm Springs. Girls from brunettes down to blonde queens. These young boys don't know what the dawn mean. I'm just a bad boy gone clean. I'm the diamond chain choker, always remain sober. Don't drink liquor and all the game's over. Need a plane, I explain it to my broker. Three bots in the hood, top down and ain't over. You know there's more, man, where that come from.
Okay, that was Welcome Back by Mace.
What's up, guys? We are back.
Episode 5 of the Brothers Yoke. Today is March 19th. I'm Justin.
I'm Jacob, and I haven't done yoga in like 4 weeks.
me for 2 weeks.
Yeah, it's been for the name of our podcast being Brothers Yoga. It's been an embarrassingly long time since I've done yoga.
To be fair, guys, we were yoging hard last semester.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay.
Yeah, that's where the name was created.
So, Jacob, we made goals two weeks ago before we took off. Do you remember them? I think I remember mine.
I think mine was to continue with the foam rolling and the... Oh, no, mine was meditation.
Meditation. Did you end up meditating at all?
I did it a few times, but on the trip that we were on, I went on a little road trip. It was just not conducive to a meditate. I did work on, like, mindfulness and being, like, present, but the actual act of meditating, have not done that.
Yep, absolutely. So, for me, I wanted to try to play some music when I was home. I got to play a little bit, but not much. But yep. I did play some music when I was at home. Play a little bit of guitar when I could.
Very nice.
Yeah, try to get a little bit better. Just kind of doodle around. But
yeah,
realized I still want to do it. But it's just gonna take some time.
Yeah, 100%. Was it nice being home?
Yeah, except it was cloudy the whole time.
Yeah, that's what Monty said.
Our friend Monty is from the same area as I am, so shout out to Monty if you ever catch wind of this, Monty. We love you, brother.
Yes.
But SHP is better than Menlo, Monty. Sorry. Oh, go Gators.
No, I always love going home, like, even if it's just for like a day or two. There's something, even if you're home, my hometown's like decent, not like A+, but it's like a pretty good hometown, I would say.
Yeah, I feel like Salem's a nice place.
Even if you're, unless your town, your hometown is like a complete, like, unless your hometown's terrible, it's always nice going back just for, there's something recharging about going home to your
Absolutely.
Hometown.
Honestly, I didn't want to come back.
Yeah.
I wanted to stay home.
Yeah.
The whole time.
Yeah, being from the Bay. Yeah. You want
that. It was nice.
That's a magical area.
Got
too.
A little darker, I think.
Yeah, I noticed you have the goggles tan line there. Or maybe it's from your glasses. I don't know.
Yeah, no, it's the tan line from the goggles, unfortunately.
Yep.
It's the curse I got to bear.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's a mark of a swimmer.
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. I had a really good spring break. JM and I went on the road trip all the way down to Death Valley, so we stopped at lots of cool hot springs.
Yeah, it seems like you guys had a lot of fun. I saw you guys did a lot of cool pit stops, it looked like.
Yeah.
Camped a little bit, right?
Yeah, so like...
Excuse you.
The trip itself was to Death Valley, but like, honestly, a lot of the attractions and the cool stuff we saw was like on the way. Like, I mean, Death Valley was cool and all.
Yeah.
And I'm sure it would have been fun to like stick around more, but like, some of the hot springs we stayed at and the scenery around the hot springs was like, that was the coolest part to me. Like, our plan was to just stop and basically camp at these hot spring sites. Yeah. And we knew it wasn't going to be too busy because it's like March. So there's a few spring break. I don't think we saw any spring break people.
Like spring breakers, quote unquote.
Yeah. Like, I don't know, young people like us, but there were almost none of those. There were like some old hippies hanging around the hot springs, and they were always really cool to chat with. And, like, we made a couple new friends, sort of. But
Was it like communicating with some hippies?
It was really interesting. They had some good stories. Like,
oh, really?
We talked to this couple, and they're from like Maine or something, and they're just in the
damn,
like,
really?
Like, they were an interesting group. They're like,
wow.
yeah, we just came from Utah. Like, we're just like living in our car, like sort of just nomads. And I'm like, that's crazy. Like, they were all tatted up and like,
shoot,
interesting type people.
Dang, but that's you get photos with them?
No, I don't know. I should have like been like, oh,
they seem like pretty cool people, honestly.
I don't even know their names, to be honest.
Oh,
but
man,
a lot. We would usually go in the hot springs like in the evening and sometimes in the morning, and it was a really nice way to like wake up and go to bed. Like, you can just look out. Like, one place had really beautiful snowy mountains like really close to us.
Oh, yeah, totally.
And it was like super nice just sitting in the hot spring. You could see the sunset and all that stuff. So I recommend anyone who wants a little adventure like within the U.S. or like wherever you are, it's pretty affordable going. And I mean, we didn't eat out. We ate out sort of at like an ice cream place, but
In-N-Out. You guys ate at In-N-Out. That's true. I saw that.
Yeah, we did.
Boo! In-N-Out. That was overrated.
You're from the Bay Area. You should like
it. I like In-N-Out, but it's not the best burger.
You keep on telling me that. You keep on saying overrated. I never once said In-N-Out was amazing food.
Okay, this is not a fair comparison, but like one of my old buddies was like, yeah, In-N-Out's better than Five Guys. I'm like, you can't compare the two because like they're different burgers.
Okay, well, for the record, I think Five Guys is even better than In-N-Out.
Yeah, I think it is. I think Fatburger is better than Five Guys.
I think I have been to Fatburger one time.
Fatburger's delicious.
My original point, though, was if you need a... I mean, we paid for gas. We each spent like $100 on groceries, which picture spending a week staying in either Airbnbs and or hotels. Think about how much that would cost. That's so expensive.
It's a lot of money.
Yeah. So
it's a lot of... It's in the thousands.
Probably.
For a week.
You stay at decent places. So I mean, we got the adventure of a little camping, you know,
meeting some interesting people.
I highly recommend
choose
a spot like, you know, a few days away, spend a couple hours in the car each day, like nothing extraordinary, and then go to your destination and plan decent like cool little things on the way. And I guarantee you on the way you're going to improvise and find a cool little stop. And it's like, absolutely. I highly recommend that. In the past like 3 years, I've had a change of heart on road trips.
Road trips are dope, dude.
Yeah.
We might be doing a bro trip.
That would be, yeah, post-graduation.
Very, 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 this is very premature, though.
Oh, yeah, he literally just mentioned this to me today.
Yeah, like, it's very premature, but bro trip.
Yeah, something.
Hence, bro trip.
Yep. Go to Canada or something.
Oh,
that'd
be dope. Yeah.
Like, early summertime in Canada, I'm sure that's gorgeous.
Who knows? We might find Bigfoot. Sorry, guys. We're working on a new program called Pro Tools, and we're kind of still getting the gist of it today. So
Tech Services was very nice, and yeah, they came out, and there's a guy named David who showed us around the equipment. Yeah. And
shout out to David.
Yeah, he's a really cool dude, and he helped us figure out this new equipment. It's kind of a cool skill to have, knowing how to work this. Like,
yeah,
I'm far, far from being an expert, but it's like, if you just know your way around it, that can get you
pretty far.
Cool. You know?
Yeah. But yeah, it was so my spring break. I didn't do much. I just went home.
Yeah.
I just swam and worked out.
We had a good time going to, where were you when you met those people?
Oh, So the first Saturday, I went to this bar called The Patio with my buddy George. And I ended up losing my buddy at closing time because he doesn't even remember where he exited. Shout out to George for being such a good sport.
He was the drunk one. I would hope he's having a good time.
Yeah, but he found his way home somehow, and he lost his phone, actually.
Oh, that sucks right there.
That's
terrible.
Why it's, like, bad. But he managed to find his way home. Shout out to George. That was unique, to say the least. But we met these Fijian transplants.
Oh, my God.
And I guess their cousin is one of the bouncers, and I ended up going on an Uber with them to downtown Mountain View, where they met these other people, and they had like this quote unquote after party, but it's really just this apartment complex that had like a jacuzzi and a pool in it.
I'm always jealous of anyone that knows like bar owners or club owner, or if you know the bouncer, like I'm always jealous that that's really cool.
Yeah. Low key though, I was just like, I want to go home. Like,
yeah, because you said you stayed till pretty late at night,
like almost 4 or 5 in the morning.
Yeah, that's a good time.
Yeah, it's we didn't drink at the apartment complex, but it was nice.
Cool little chill time.
Met some interesting cats there. I mean, it's only a few of us, to be honest with you. And then this past Saturday, I went out for St. Patrick's Day.
Oh yeah,
at Molly McGee's in downtown Mountain View with my friend Caroline and her friend Maddie. Shout out to those two. That was very fun, and we should definitely hang out again when I come back home.
Did you drink a Guinness?
You know, I don't like Guinness.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I'm an AMF kind of guy, unfortunately.
Oh, okay. All right.
They were sweet, though. Yeah. The AMS, because they put so much Sprite in there.
So explain to me what's in there, and anyone out there who is not a big
drinker. Like that blue drink. I don't even know what's really in it. It's like a lot of hard liquor, from my understanding.
Yeah, like,
and they put like Sprite or 7-Up, like some lemony soda.
So do you slam it or do you sip it?
Oh, you sip it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It's like a pretty fairly tall drink.
Okay.
It's like that Mai Tai looking drink, I guess, that like neon blue.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, at least that's the best way to describe it.
Yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, well, I had a really interesting drink at this like trendy bar in Salem when we went out for St. Patrick's Day. It was like Irish whiskey, Guinness, something called Lapsang. It's like a type of tea.
Oh, Lapsang tea?
Uh-huh.
Oh, okay.
They added that in there. And that's then rude. Lemon and...
That sounds really, like, trendy and it's really well, fancy.
It was kind of sophisticated and a little bit, like, ritzy type of hipsterish, but it was pretty good. I sipped it, and it was pretty decent.
That sounds good. I mean, yeah. I don't blame you.
I had that in a beer, so...
Damn.
Yeah, usually I'm just a type, like a, I don't know, whiskey type of, or just beer or something like that. I usually won't order a fancy cocktail, but...
Yeah. Molly McGee's had a dance floor. That was fun.
Yes.
Yeah. Same thing with Patio. Patio's fun. Had a dance floor.
Yep. Yep.
But like the cover charge for Molly McGee's is like $20. See, that's like really expensive for me. Like,
no, I understand that. I understand that, but I don't go to enough clubs, but I sort of feel like that's somewhat normal, like getting into a club. It's like,
yeah. I mean, honestly though, it makes sense for them as a business, because think how much money they'll make like for something like St. Patrick's Day.
Yeah.
So
but it's also
make a lot.
It's also a bummer though, because it's like, okay, you guys are getting money for liquor too. So it's like, do you really have to charge me an additional $20?
Yeah, that's like, very true.
I don't know. I feel like a lot of people show up already like good.
Yeah,
and you just show up to dance. You know.
Yeah, I just I showed up sober, and then.
Oh really?
Like, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm a lightweight.
I have yet to go to a club in Seattle or Tacoma. Actually, I go to a fair amount of bars, but
yeah. Possible next idea.
Yep, yep.
But yeah, spring break was fun. You know, had to finish up some work, obviously, for school.
Yep.
We're back in the grind. We're 6 weeks down.
I know. It's crazy.
On the job
it's
train.
Flying by.
Yeah. I've officially committed to a job.
Yeah, you're putting the pieces together.
Yeah, so I committed to a job down in Santa Clara, California,
mm-hmm.
called CORE. I'll be interning there as of right now part-time, but those hours will increase, and I'm also looking for like a swim coaching gig to make
very
some
nice.
Money as of right now. What about you, Jacob? You looking right now, or are you just kind of...
Yeah, haven't done a lot of looking. I'm kind of slacking, to be honest, but...
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm still studying for my CSCS. I got to take a practice exam today, but I also got to write up a paper, mm-hmm. so that's the plan.
Yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, it's one of those things you just got to, like, chip away at a little
bit.
Yeah,
it's kind of annoying.
I think I'm going to make some time, like, every morning and just be like, Jacob, you just go on LinkedIn or go on whatever
Indeed,
and just send out, like, I don't know, send out a couple emails or whatever. So, should be good. I don't know. It's weird. Like, even though I had a big spring break, I don't have a ton to talk about. We went on. The trip was really cool. Like I said, I definitely...
We're passing notes. Like little schoolgirls.
I can't even read what that says.
No, don't worry about it.
All right, well, I don't know. We'll cut that part out. That's silliness.
Yeah. That's at 13:51. But yeah, I mean, you had a pretty fun spring break.
Yep.
Sounds
yep.
like. Mine was just kind of just chill out.
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah. But yeah, I guess that's about it, guys.
Yeah, 14 minutes in. You know, we'll do a little music break and then we'll liven things up.
Yeah.
We'll talk about what we're going to do, what our plans are, thoughts.
Might be a shorter podcast today, guys, just FYI. We're kind of coming off spring break and stuff like that. So.
Oh, no, you know what? No, I have something I want to talk about after this.
Okay.
All right.
Got it.
Everybody made it. Infiltrated. Infiltrated. Activated.
right, guys, you just heard Pop Music by M. Yeah, that's the name of the band, just the letter M.
Cool, cool. So what do you want to talk about, man?
It's a great jam. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I had to give a little presentation today.
Oh, how'd that go?
I hate public speaking. It's given me tremendous fear in the past. It's weird because I've never bombed a speech. Or I've never really, like, failed. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So worse
things.
In some ways, it's a bit of an irrational fear because I've never drastically screwed something up, but I think it's something that a lot of people out there are scared of, and a lot of people out there, like, have a fear of going up in front of a group of people and, like, speaking. But I've thought about it a lot, and I think it's such a valuable life skill to say that you're good at public speaking, which I think not a lot of people can say. Like, so many people go up there and stutter or, like, sweat and stuff like that. And it's very interesting. Like, no matter what profession you're in, at the very least, it can't hurt, you know?
Yeah.
Especially at, like, higher level positions, you have a presentation, you're pitching a new idea for a company, you're presenting a new structure within your organization, you're introducing someone new or a new program, way of doing things or something. Maybe you're a marketing firm, you have to present a product to potential investors, like whatever it might be. I just feel like it's like good to have. So it bugs me a little bit that I'm so scared of it, but I feel like, especially with what happened today, I've gotten tools to like get better with it. Like, mm-hmm. one thing, like for me personally, like when I have to do something, even if it's not public speaking, if it's something that makes me nervous or gives me
some form
like,
of anxiety.
Yeah, form of anxiety, something like that. What I did yesterday is I wrote out my week. So it's Sunday night. I'm going to write out what my plan is for the week. I get my pen, my paper, and I write out what my goals are, what my aspirations. So, and then I was like, all right, tomorrow is the presentation. I have to give it at 2. In the past, like before taking exams and stuff like that, like I would get my stomach hurts. That's the thing that makes me so nervous. Or that's my symptom of the anxiety is the stomach ache. So I'm like, all right, how am I going to get around this? Because I have to give this presentation in front of like 20, 30 something people. I can't really even remember. But what I find helps me personally is like if I just talk to someone in the hours beforehand, so the presentation's at 2. If I sit around by myself and like mope or like ruminate about these fears that I have in my head and think about the presentation.
Oh, it gets worse.
Then it's going to get way worse.
It's performance anxiety. That's
yeah,
what it is.
So it's like same thing with if you have to do an athletic event, if you are going on stage to sing or something like that, be prepared and know your stuff.
Like, the best thing I ever learned is like practice makes perfect. You know, mm-hmm. like the concept of like, well, perfect practice makes perfect performance. That's what I found out. So like when it comes to like public speaking, for me, I just like, for me, if it's like a really big presentation, I practice my speech over and over and over.
How many times do you practice it?
A lot.
Do you have it down verbatim to
almost verbatim? Like the big ones that like the best ones I had, like I practiced like for verbatim almost.
Huh. See, I like that's.
And I get like if there's like ever like a kink I have, I always like try to start back over because
mm-hmm.
like I want to make sure like every slide is like fine. Like I had a presentation today, but it's more just it was a group presentation, but it was very like open ended where you just ask questions and whatnot,
right?
Or like you just ask like a focus question essentially.
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't really have to do too much for it. It was just like knowing the gist of what I wanted to talk about.
Yeah, that's interesting what you say about the practicing because I will practice it, but I also will say things a little different each time. So, like, for me, what helps is if I really thoroughly know the information, then it allows me to improvise a little bit while I'm up there.
Yeah, totally.
Now, I'm not saying I'm up there making stuff up, but I'll deviate from my original thought
pattern.
But,
like, you know, like, there's, like, different routes you can take, though, which is always nice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, and so once I'm up there, usually I do fine. Like, I'll have little bouts of fear, but, like, it's that leading up to it, or God forbid, the worst possible scenario is if I'm going, like, you know, there's 4 presentations today. If I have to go 3rd, then I'm already in a bad spot. Cause I
yeah,
have to
I'd rather go 1st or 2nd.
I ran into my professor today before class, and I was like, hey, do you mind if I just go 1st today? Like, can I just, and he's like, he kind of gave me a weird look, and I'm like, He's like, yeah, sure, that's fine with me. And I'm like, okay, thanks. Like, and then we walked in the class, and I was like, do you mind if I just get this out of the way? And he's like, oh, yeah, sure, I don't care. So I'm like, oh, thank God. So I can go right up there and bite the bullet. Because one thing that someone said to me, which impacts the way I think about this, is, and this goes for public speaking, this goes for, I think, performance art, like if you're in a play or something, usually a lot of people say once you get up on stage, you're good. It's that anticipation that kills people. So it's like you only have to be brave for that first second, and then you're on your rails, and then you can navigate the way you want to. Mm-hmm. So it's like you only have to be brave for a second.
Once and then you're it up just kind of takes over after that.
Yeah. And so that pre-anticipation is what kills me. So back to my original point when I was talking about was talking with you and talking with anyone else, I could talk to pull someone aside and just start rambling to them. If I have something to distract my mind away from, I don't want to think about anything in the presentation. I know it. I have it down.
Yeah.
I practice it enough. So I just need to rant to someone or get fired up about something. Then I walk into the classroom and then I do a great job. Like, the presentation day went great. It was fine. Like, I had really not much to worry about, but it was the pre-anxiety beforehand.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, totally. I mean, for me, I used to get, like, really anxious before, like, any big, like, swimming competition, like, any meet, like, any event. I got over that. And the the biggest thing for me was because you're just worried about the outcome and not the actual process of it.
Yeah.
That's interesting. One thing that helped me overcome, like, a lot of fears with, like, presenting and stuff is, like, worrying, like, focusing more on the process and like each individual step instead of worrying about like the overall outcome, because you can't control the outcome.
So,
but you have control of like what you can say or like.
So, meaning focusing on the issues of what you're talking about, like focus on the content.
Yeah, focus on the content. Focus on like what you practice. Like, don't worry about the outcome, because if you focus on the things you can quote unquote control, I know that's a very blasé or not blasé, but like generic thing people say.
Right.
Like, you definitely have more control of the outcome. Mm-hmm. I think people don't, some people don't recognize that, or like some people are just so confident, I feel like, that they just can get up there and do, or like get up there, do your presentation, or just get up and like perform at their at any stage or level.
Right.
But
yeah, for a lot of people, I think there's a lot. I mean, that's probably like the number one fear of people. If you ask people, what are you afraid of? How many people are going to say public speaking? Probably 95% of them.
Oh, absolutely.
That's a universal fear, and it's like, I don't know. It's interesting. There was something else I was going to add. You had a point that I wanted to. What was the last thing you said? Focusing on the process and not the outcome.
Yeah. What were you going to say?
I don't know. I lost it. That's okay.
No, it's all good.
I still think it's important to... Oh, no, yeah, that's what it was. Do you have any fears that exist? So you mentioned the fear of like a large sporting event, or you sometimes get afraid of getting up and talking. Do you have any fears today that you still deal with?
You want to know?
If you're comfortable talking about it.
I think it's kind of embarrassing, but like going to the doctors and getting a flu shot.
Oh, no, that's probably number two is, what are you afraid of? Public speaking. What's number two? Needles. Like, yeah. That's probably 90%.
No, as a little kid, still to this day, I hate needles, dude.
So would you donate blood? Probably not.
Hell no.
Yeah.
I remember when I was at home, like winter 2014, this is when I was taking time off school. I got like the flu, and they needed to take like a blood test for me.
Yeah,
I remember the lady like getting really close. I'm like, "Whoa!" And she's like, "Yo, don't do that." Like,
oh, because it'll tense up and
poke you in the wrong spot.
Oh my god!
And I'm like, "Sorry, I just don't like needles. Like, I hate needles."
Does it help if you look away when they're doing it?
No, it's because it's worse.
Oh my god! Yeah.
Well, even if I look, it's worse. I don't know what's better. Like either way, it's bad.
Needles are a weird one.
I get really anxious around needles.
That's one that, I mean, for me, public speaking is up there, but needles don't bother me as much.
Yeah.
I go get blood drawn, or I'll donate blood and stuff, and that's one thing where it's like, okay.
Yeah.
Here's an interesting one. Are you afraid of the ritual with doctors, the sitting down, the talking with them, Some people are scared of that element.
You just tell the truth, honestly.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Because I want a clean bill of health.
Yeah.
By the time I die.
Yeah. Like, if you keep secrets, never keep secrets from your doctor. That's one thing people always say.
Sorry, I'm trying to pull something up.
Yeah. You want to know another one that I'm scared of is like open water. That's like,
oh, that's another reasonable fear.
I went wake surfing for the first time this summer, and I hadn't been in a lake in a while, hadn't been on like a boat or whatever. We used to do this when I was younger, and I just didn't think about it, and I was fine. But I like the first time I got into the water and the boat pulled away, mm-hmm. and I was out there with the wakeboard on my white and my life vest and everything. And this lake is like, I don't know, 200, 300 feet deep.
Yeah.
But that's deep. But it was murky and I couldn't see my feet.
Oh, okay.
And so the boat pulled away and I was sitting there and like everyone else had gone. Like I was like maybe second to last person to go that day or for that first round of like doing it. So I was sitting out there for a minute, and I started hyperventilating. Like before even swimming or doing anything, I was sitting out there, and I was like, I could feel myself breathing, and it was like the water was constricting on my chest.
Oh my god!
Because I couldn't see under there.
And oh my goodness!
It's the fear of the unknown.
Yeah.
Like I'm like.
It's a lake, though.
I'm like, I don't know what lake monster could be.
Oh. How old were you when this happened?
Oh, this is like last summer.
Oh my god!
It's fear of open water. It's a real thing. Yeah. But I'm not saying I had a panic attack and I had to climb out of the water. But for the brief 3 seconds when my mind ran away with me, I imagined. I'm going to paint a little picture for you, like in the reeds of the bottom of the lake.
Oh, stop it.
See what I'm saying? You see? You're scared of it too.
This is like freaking Loch Ness Monster.
Maybe a fish or like a large crustacean is buried into there. And it shakes a little, shakes the dust off, and it climbs up to that surface.
Yeah, that's scary.
See what I mean? Like fear of water, murky water is creepy.
My fear is actually like, in terms of nature, is actually like being in a forest and then like stumbling upon something you don't want to stumble upon like, Bigfoot or something like that.
Oh, okay.
It's like a weird like fear I have, but like you know how there's all these like stories of like strange creatures and like the woods and stuff, like that creeps me out.
Or not even strange creatures, a bear. Like if you stumble upon a bear.
Oh no, that's like no bueno right there.
Yeah.
Because when you're in the water, you can get out. And you don't even have to go there.
Well, not necessarily. Like if someone dumps you off a boat in the middle of the ocean.
Okay, well that's different. Mm-hmm. But you know what I mean. It's very avoidable.
So is the forest in that same way, though.
In a way, yeah.
Yeah, that's an interesting one. Yeah. Is it the fear of being isolated? Would you have the same fear in like the desert or like?
Oh, the desert would freak me out too.
Really?
Oh yeah.
For fear of like not having water or something.
Yeah, not having water, like because it
heat stroke or something.
Heat stroke. Yeah.
Yeah, that's a spooky one.
Yeah, that's think about like traveling through like a desert, sand's blown everywhere, you're thirsty, you're tired, it's hot, and you're dragging too.
That's creepy. I've heard that's one of the worst ways to go is like dying of thirst or something. I mean, that's terrible. Like 3 or 4 days of like just misery.
Yeah. Yeah. So yeah, no bueno right there.
What was the other thing I had attached? Oh, yeah. How good does it feel, though, when you finally conquer that fear? Like, in my experience, it always feels so good.
Oh, it feels really good.
Whether it's, like, finally getting the presentation done or...
finishing up that exam or that race or
like,
that.
Ooh, that's just... Or, I mean, like, for the first time conquering a fear, like, if you had to say in... Okay, I'm not, like, jinxing you or whatever, but say in a terrible situation, one of us got very sick and we had to get a bunch of shots or get, like, a bunch of blood drawn or something.
Yeah.
Eventually, you get used to it, and you're like, I conquered that. That's good.
I don't know if you get used to that.
You don't think so?
Nope. I know so.
But you haven't been exposed to it that much, though.
Well, I know someone who had to go to the hospital all the time, and they had to get poked.
And they continued to... Oh, did it make it worse, almost?
Yeah. Oh. It sucks.
Well, maybe that's not the best example. Yeah. All right, well, maybe if you love the water, but you're scared of murky water.
Okay, that's...
And you...
Yeah,
okay,
that's a big one.
All right, yeah, my first thing was bad.
Yeah,
but.
Because, like drowning and, like, open water fear is, like, a legitimate fear.
Yeah.
And, like, that's very... That's probably more easily overcomable if you think about it.
Yeah. Yeah, I would agree with that.
Because it's just some practice. Like... Oh, another thing is, like, you know, when you go hiking, like a mountainous area,
uh-huh.
and, like, you see a deep ridge.
Oh, yeah.
And then you look down.
Mm-hmm.
When I was going to my senior year of high school, I went to Taos, New Mexico.
Oh, yeah.
And there's a lot of canyons, but, like, the canyons go, like, way
down. Yeah.
So we're walking around, like, up the plateau area, you know, because, like, that's where, like, the roads are and stuff. So, mm-hmm. like, there's no barrier. So you can just walk over and look around.
Oh, that's
right. And one of the girls, I felt so bad. Like, she was freaked out. Like,
dang.
Like, she had a fear of heights. She had to look away towards the road and stuff.
Jeez.
And I was like, yeah, that sucks.
Yeah, it's almost worse when you see someone else. Like, my fear around, like, when I'm with friends and my friend gets too close to the edge, that gives me the creeps more than myself. Because, like, if I saw my friend fall, that's, like, almost worse than me falling.
Oh, my God,
it
is. It's so bad.
Hearing someone scream as they fall off the edge of a cliff.
Oh, hell no.
Like, that's so dark.
Yeah. That is dark.
That's a creepy one.
That's a creepy one. Dang.
But
people at night, you know, when you're alone and then you run into people at night.
Oh, the dark makes everything that much. Like, I mean, when we were on this spring break trip, we'd be at these campgrounds and you just assume that everyone is like out to get you or, you know, some.
Yeah.
Like, I typecast people because it's like, I don't know, some dude walking around in the dark, like, you're up to no good, you're in the dark. But then again, the rational part is like, okay, come on, it's in a campground.
Yeah,
he's camping
totally.
Too, he's enjoying nature. Yeah. There's nothing wrong with that. But in your head, your irrational mind wants to be like, oh, this guy's coming to axe murder you or something, you know?
Okay, that creeps me out too.
Yeah.
Also, like, even people in a bar, like a dark lit bar.
Yeah.
When it's loud and like people are being rambunctious.
I get that, but not
for me, because I'm a quiet guy. Like,
yeah,
I'm fairly quiet.
I get that, but I also, like, if someone's being loud and rambunctious, you can almost smile and appreciate that they're having a good time.
Yeah, you know? No, that's not what I mean. Like, you know, when someone kind of comes over and like tries to talk to you, and it's like very awkward and strange.
Yeah, that's a little weird.
Like, I didn't tell you this. My experience this past weekend, like, I was waiting for my two friends because they went to the bathroom. So I was like, oh, just watch her drink something. Like, okay, whatever, man. Like, you two, you do.
Well, you're doing them a favor. You don't want them to get
roofied. Yeah, I was like, yeah, that's the idea. It was like, you guys do what you got to do.
Mm-hmm.
I'll take care of it. And this dude comes over here, and he's, like, trying to cause a problem. He's, like, a middle-aged dude. He's, like, kind of bald. He's, like, big. I'm, like, taller than him, though, but he's, like, he's trying to say something about my haircut, you know?
Oh, it's weird.
And I'm like, huh? So I couldn't hear him, like, a couple times, and, like, I couldn't hear him. He's like, he just said something about my haircut.
Do you have a smile on his face?
Yeah, it's kind of like a smile and like that kind of cheeky grin, though.
Yeah, he's probably hammered.
Yeah, and he's like, oh, I'm just trying to tell you so you know. And then I could have either been like, hey, at least I'm like, yo, fat ass,
oh,
I can grow some hair. But instead I was like,
bar fight.
Yeah, I was this close to starting a problem. Like, I was about to be like, why are you trying to start something?
I have a pretty...
I just straight up went, whatever, dude. And then I just went back on my phone.
I mean, yeah, like 90% of the time when you're... I mean, I have a pretty high buffer for... if I mean, I have a surprisingly high patience for drunk people. Like, if I'm in a bar and someone comes up trying to chat with me, I'll smile and laugh along with them because I don't know what kind of state they're in.
Yeah.
If they're just being weird because they're being outgoing because they've had drinks, I've got no problem with that.
Yeah.
Like, even if they're saying something that's outlandish... 90% of the time, you have to just smile. Like,
yeah.
And if I don't hear what they say, you can bet I'm going to smile and be like, yeah, man.
Yeah, no, but this guy's just trying to start a problem, you know?
Did it seem like that?
Yeah, because he's with his homies, you know?
Like, oh, so was he like, was he sort of like posturing in front of his friends?
Yeah,
almost?
And then he's like, told his friends, like, oh, dude, check that guy out. He's like, he looks like a joke.
Oh, okay, that's a different thing.
Yeah, because his friend did a round, like, literally like, made eye contact. I'm like, oh, wow, you guys are just trying to feel better about yourself. Like, come on, man.
So were these all how old did you say he was?
Probably in their 40s, honestly.
And the friends were too?
Yeah.
Friends were guys?
Yeah.
And they were white dudes?
No.
Oh.
Nope. They're like Middle Eastern, I think. Indian.
Oh, that's an interesting.
Yeah. But usually, like, you know, and they're like a lot older than me. I'm like, okay, whatever. Whatever, my guy.
That's
not to be racist or anything like that.
Well, I'm trying to picture that, and I'm like, what the heck? Would they have any business talking to you about that?
Yeah, and I'm just chilling on my phone. I'm like, you know, like this. Like, I'm literally leaning against the corner like, yeah, whatever.
Okay. When the first dude made the comment, did he have a smile on his face?
Yeah, he's kind of like, hey, like, your hair. That's all I could hear because it was so loud. I'm like, okay, like, I didn't ask for no problems, bro. But
he might have just been trying to give you a compliment.
No, but then he was like, trying to create, like, I can tell he's being like cheeky.
He's just making fun.
Yeah,
that's messed up.
I'm like, all right, whatever, dude, I just got this cut today, like, I don't care.
Yeah, that's silly. Yeah, you
I'm
shouldn't
like,
worry about that.
I'm like, It's like, you're too old to be doing that, bro.
Yeah, sometimes.
No, that's just, like, not cool in general.
I don't think I've that story sounds familiar because it feels like I've had something else happen, like, sort of similar to that, where someone way too old to be picking a fight with me was, like, dealing with some petty something.
Yeah, he's just like, being petty. Him and his buddies, I can tell, are just petty.
Yeah.
And they're just trying to, like, go out, like, to a bar to, like, hopefully meet somebody, you know? Yeah. Like, I can tell what kind of people they are. They're, like, kind of petty old guys. Like, yeah.
Was it late? Like,
it was, like, about mid. It was actually, like, clicking on midnight.
Yeah.
So like, I'm, probably. And obviously I'm, like, so I cut myself off because I had, like, 3 solid drinks. I'm, like, okay, I'm good.
Right.
You know, and then I'll just wait for Caroline and Maddie. And then I'm, this dude just pops up. I'm, like, yo, like.
Yeah, it's silly.
Can I just relax? But, yeah.
Yeah, speaking of which, there's, like, there's a span of, like, 3 or 4 bars we should go to on,
6th Avenue?
Not 6th. It's, like, a totally different neighborhood that I've never been to. But
oh,
you,
really?
But you drive through it on the way to, like, Lakewood.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
So you, it's, like, South Tacoma Way, I think.
Oh, the South Tacoma Way area? Yeah.
You know, there's, like, 4 or 5, they're not really fancy bars, they're, like, taverns. Like,
oh,
they look,
gotcha.
Like, sort of... little bit less nice but still interesting area of there's
That'd
a span
fun.
Of like 5 or 6 bars, like.
Yeah, that's fun. College talk, guys.
yep
we're motivated for bars.
yeah
unfortunately
sure. No, well, I don't know. I was talking with JM and it's like, I don't know, like, I haven't really seen that much of Tacoma, which is kind of silly because, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I can see what she means.
Well, I just mean, well,
there's not much to do.
But you
all the time, like, it's raining a lot.
a lot of people from, okay, I hate to pick on people from the Bay, but people love to trash cities that aren't the Bay Area. Like, and this is not you, of the people that I know, like, you do this not that much, but I've met some people where their favorite pastime is to talk about how shitty every other
is true.
Excuse my French there for a minute.
Yeah.
All these people always want to talk about how bad all these other cities are except the Bay Area.
Well,
it's just like,
like, I've been in New York. New York's pretty awesome, I'm not gonna lie.
My point of saying that is, like, there's cool stuff out there if you go look for it.
Yeah.
And
like, Seattle's a nice city. I love Seattle. Like,
even Tacoma, though, I think there's cool spots if you go.
I think there's
cool
spots. I just don't think, like, we know the spots, though.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
That's why I bring up this area with 5 or 6 bars, because it's like, that could be a cool area if we're tired of going to the same 4 spots on 6th Ave.
Yeah.
Mix it up and go to this weird
little.
Not
to mention, I just eat most of the time.
That's a fair point, too.
Food is good.
Yeah, there's some very good Asian food here in Tacoma.
Yeah.
I've appreciated you and JM showing me all these.
I do want some pho.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Ugh, that does sound good.
What do you think? Should we wrap it?
Yeah, we should start wrapping it up, huh? So, you got any goals this week? Oh, we have a little announcement.
Oh, okay.
About this Friday, right?
Uh-huh.
So this Friday, we're going to have another podcast. We're going to have our friends still in the works, though.
Yeah,
we got to make sure
they're tentative.
Cool. We got to make sure they're cool with it first, but it'll be fun. Today was kind of short, guys, and I know we're a little disconnected at times.
Yeah, we both had busy days. It's like lingering stuff from midterms, but
yeah, we're really tired. Honestly. I didn't get back home till like midnight.
Yeah,
and fall asleep till like 2 or 2:30 at night.
Yep.
So I'm like running on fumes right now.
Yeah, I know.
So we're a little disconnected.
Do you have goals for this week?
My goal, definitely do the CSCS practice exam, which I'm about to do.
Mm-hmm.
And keep it simple.
Keep it
simple this week. I got an assignment, but keep it simple.
That's good. At the top of my paper, I have foam roll because I need to be foam rolling every night. I listened to this podcast and this dude talked about he hasn't missed a day of stretching in like 5 years or something. And I was like, goals. I need to do that.
Yeah.
I need to work on stretching out my IT band, quads, stuff, prepare for this race that's coming up here in like a month, basically, a little bit over a month. That's kind of scary, but
yeah.
Foam roll, stretch. I have.
You excited for it?
I'm getting excited.
You're getting excited. I saw this
dude on Instagram, this comedian that I follow. He, with little to no training, mm-hmm. he ran the LA Marathon. Guess how long it took him?
Oh, shoot. I don't know. I don't even know what a good marathon
yeah,
time
that's true.
Is.
That's true. There's no context here. Okay. Yeah. Elite runners that are still recreational run it in 3 hours.
Damn.
So
did he run it under 3 hours?
Very, very serious. No, he did not.
Oh.
Very serious, like, but still for fun runners, run it like 3 hours to 3 hours and 30 minutes. Good runners probably run it like 3:30 to 4. I'm not going to say my goal because it's whatever. And then he ran it in like 5 hours and 30 minutes.
Oh, Jesus.
Which I have to give him props, though, because, I mean, at least he
That's a long 5 hours, though.
That is.
Oh, actually, real quick, I want to give a quick shout-out to the King Aquatic Club, who finished, I believe the guys finished first at Speedo Sectionals this past weekend, and the girls finished second. Quick shout-out. Also to Logger Swimming, I believe one girl. Yeah, sorry, I forgot
this week.
I forgot to mention this because it's a big performance month. And also, I believe they qualified one girl, Kelly, who we kind of talked here and there, but shout out to her. She's going to Nationals this week.
Whoa.
And also to my club team back home, PASA. They did a great job at Texas Sectionals a few weeks ago.
Oh, yeah.
And they won the meet there, which is a big deal.
Very nice.
So a couple shout outs there.
Yeah, there's a lot of people doing good things.
Yeah, a lot of great performances going on. Yep. So good luck to those who are performing, as well as shout out to those who have performed and reached their goals. And if they haven't, put it on the list.
yes.
But yeah, going back to your goal, sorry.
No, that's okay.
Yeah.
That's basically it. I need a foam roll. I need to stretch every night. I need to keep on with my running and mindfulness along with the meditation. You know what? I'm going to try and meditate. I need to put that on there. I'm writing that down right now.
Yeah.
Because that did not happen over the break, but I'm still serious about making that happen.
Well, yep. So Jacob, we're gonna put on some closing music to hype you guys up.
Yep.
This is a high school throwback.
Yeah,
if not a junior high school, the dance throwback.
Yep.
It's kind of funny. We kind of found it randomly again.
But then you listen to it and you're like, this song is like middle school, like early middle school for us, which is for me is like 2007 and 2008.
I
was gonna say 2000, seven. Yeah.
2007. I was in seventh grade.
Yep. All right, guys, I hope you have a fantastic week. Yeah. Expect possibly another show later in the week.
Yeah, and it'll be more connected. This week is just kind of a reconnect kind of.
Yeah, we've got a little bit of technical difficulties, a little bit of lingering midterm stuff, but
glad you guys can join along. And actually, I don't mind it being short because
Hopefully we covered some cool things. I thought the talk about fears was interesting.
And
that was
also,
good conversation.
And maybe we'll bring that up again, but also you find some of the stuff kind of funny, sort of relatable.
Yeah,
but here's right. A cyclone.
Yep.
Oh my goodness. What? Hey. Oh, oh my god.
She moves her.